to another walk with Harvey. Now today we are parked at Bloody Bridge and we're heading up to Rocky Mountain. It sounds like a Sylvester Stallone film. Rosie's already heard that twice. And in the back we've got Holly and Harvey. So yeah, I don't know how long this one's going to take us. I'm not following a designated route or anything. We're just going by the map and compass. So Rosie's looking a bit worried there, but I'm pretty sure I know where I'm going anyway. We'll find out anyway. So yeah, we're going to get going, speak to you in a bit. Bye. So this bridge here, I think this is a more recent bridge. It's not the original Bloody Bridge. The story is that in 1641, a Con McGuinness ordered the killing of, numbers vary. When I was reading up on it this morning, it goes from as little as six to as many as like 30 or 40 people were killed at Bloody Bridge in 1641. So yeah, the history seems a bit sketchy on it. I think the story was there were Protestants from Newry and there was to be a deal made where they were swapped for some Irish prisoners and that fell through. So the yeah, they were killed here. You should know more about that, Rosie, being from here.
No, I don't.
No.
You know more about it.
Anyway, yeah, this is the famous Bloody Bridge. Let's get going. 1641.
It's a long time ago.
It was a long time ago. Mm-hmm. I thought the older bridge was further down from that new bridge, but then there's this one as well. Oh, I don't know. Somebody tell me in the comments. Not far from the car park at Bloody Bridge, you get to the river. That's a great place for swimming because there's a few pools formed in the river that are great for jumping into. So in the summer months you quite often see groups of kids jumping in, organised and non-organised groups. Yeah, but it's a great place for river walking and doing that type of thing. Well, I thought I'd lost my tripod. This pocket here.
Uh-huh.
So I've just ran back, nearly half the way back to the car looking for it.
And where was it?
Yeah.
What are you?
Idiot. Right, just having a wee break at the quarry here. Sourdough bread and olives. Not really.
Sourdough
bread. No, it's vegan sausage rolls again and peanut butter and jam sandwiches. Now these marks in the stone, this is how they used to split the stone. I can't remember the name of the technique, but I'll look it up when I get back. Okay, that's us at the Mourne Wall. Donard up ahead there, a family that we met earlier on heading up that direction. So good luck to them. And in the distance there, we've got Binion from last week's sunrise camp that I did. And I think that's, is that Lamagan and Cove and Burner in the far distance there? And Rosie there, taking a layer off. Are you warm again?
I am, yeah.
Okay, we're going to head along the wall here, and I think that's Rocky Mountain in the distance there. So we got Harvey and Holly over the stile there with a bit of a struggle as usual. Now this path that goes on from here straight ahead once you get to the Mourne Wall, that's the famous brandy pad, the old smuggling route that they used to take through the Mournes to avoid capture by the nasty customs. But we're not going that way today. We're going to go head towards Rocky Mountain, which I think we can see just in the distance there. And I think we're going to get in a bit of boggy water here. So she's going on the wall just to avoid this boggy bit. Now we've got a bit of a dilemma. Rosie's made a very good choice there because this bit looks fairly unpassable. I'm going to explore a bit further down, see if we can get across. I think I might, should have stayed on the other side of the wall. Let's have a look anyway. Right, so change of plan there. We got a little bit down the Mourne Wall. I was thinking we could follow the Mourne Wall all the way down and find a path to Rocky Mountain that way. Trying to cut corners a wee bit, but I'm checking the map again here from the where it says the Bog of Donard. That probably should have given me a clue. Bog of Donard. That's why it was all boggy. But yeah, the brandy pad goes on, as I said, down from this way, but there's a left turn off the brandy pad, which brings us back along towards the Rocky Mountain. So it's probably the best route to take, especially considering all the bogs that we were trying to get through.
And that's,
yeah, that's where we're trying to get to in the distance, that peak. So yeah, good to know if you're doing this route, Rocky Mountain from Bloody Bridge. Yeah, you possibly can do the wall, but yeah, just be wary that there is a lot of boggy ground around it. So we're going to try taking the path off the brandy pad. Just spotted the Devil's Coach Road in the distance. I'll zoom in so you can see it. We've definitely come too far for the turn we were looking for, so we're going to head back and see if we can spot it on the way back up. If not, we're going to try the left-hand side of the Mourne Wall to try and get to Rocky Mountain. Not giving up yet. So not too much further back up the brandy pad. We think we may have found a path. What do you think? Rosie's not sure, because not too far on from the path, it does look pretty boggy. We're just going to try. All we can do is try.
All we can do is try.
Yeah, so we've negotiated our way across that boggy bit. Not too boggy, not too, well, boggy but not too deep, if you know what I mean. So Rosie's only a little bit behind me, and Rocky Mountain is just ahead of us now. So looks like we are going to make the summit today. Don't speak too soon. So last big obstacle here before we get up towards the peak. But there's a few good crossing points here, so we're not too bad. Water is very brown, very peaty.
Are you hoping for a fall in?
I was hoping for £250 from you being framed. So how is this walk compared to previous walks you've been on with me, Rosie?
Long.
Yeah?
Long.
Is it longer than Doan or Doan or however you pronounce it?
Well, it will be by the time we finish.
And that was in the middle of winter. Do you not prefer this one in the summer?
Oh, yeah, no, I prefer the summer, definitely.
coming back off Rocky Mountain. We followed the wall back and the path is actually okay. Well, Holly's testing it out for us. I don't think it's that deep, but we'll soon find out. Whatever you do now, don't fall backwards into that big puddle. Yeah, this is the bit we were struggling with earlier. I'm wondering, is that why they've got the bits jutting out there for this very reason? Okay. It's fine if you're on your own, but it's only when you've got dogs it becomes an issue, isn't it? Right, I think we'll let the dogs make their own way across here, so let's see how they get on. Right, Rosie, you call her across. Don't we? Yeah. Holly! Wait, Harvey, go on.
Come on, Harvey.
Jump.
Come on, Harvey.
Oh, no, go. You can swim, Harvey. What's wrong with you? Colin. Go, Harvey. Go.
Come on.
Yeah. I'm glad I didn't walk through that bit. Okay, so we're back down at the quarry now, and it's just a quarry track back to a Bloody Bridge car park. So far we've done 7 miles and we've been out for over 7 hours, so not a very fast pace, but doesn't matter when you're in the hills how fast you're going. So yeah, probably another mile back down to Bloody Bridge. I'll put the final time on there, but before the batteries run out again, I thought I'd say yeah, thanks for watching, and hopefully we'll see you on another one. You coming on the next one, Rosie?
I don't know, I'll have a wee think about it.
All right, cheers. See you again, bye.